thanks for being here. I'm Daniel Lakovich. I'm with Flottweg. We're at the Rhinegeist Brewery in Cincinnati, and I'm here with Cole Hackbarth. Cole, thanks for being here.
Yeah, thank you.
So basically, we're here to visit, just to talk about your continuing expansions. It's been a journey, I know, from inception to now, so it's always exciting to come visit you because every time I walk in here, there's something new going on, so that's super exciting.
And we have this massive brewery, 20,000 square foot.
Incredible history.
Yeah.
Tell us about the history of this building.
So it was the original packaging hall for the Christian Moreland Brewery pre-prohibition. So back in those days, they did upwards of 300,000 barrels a year, just throughout Cincinnati in the Midwest, which is pretty incredible.
Highlight there, even through Prohibition area, which I know there's some tunnels around here somewhere.
There are. Originally, the tunnels were for lagering beer. Pre-refrigeration, they had to store the ice and the beer, you know, under the tunnels where it could be kept cold. Obviously, Cincinnati's famous for its speakeasies during Prohibition. A lot of those tunnels were converted and into that. So it's been very cool to step into this old brewing building and kind of bring that life back to it.
Absolutely, and you definitely have done that. You said 11,000 barrels at the beginning. Where are you now?
We're now at about 100,000 barrels.
100,000
barrels.
Just over. Wow.
Yep.
That's incredible. So talking about your expansion, right? It's step by step, obviously. You're having to maximize space as well. So Flottweg has gotten involved with you, obviously, with separation equipment, right? Mm-hmm. And you first got the separator. Talk to me about how that evolved.
Yeah, I mean, as we were growing, obviously, you're always looking for process optimization. And the bigger you get, the faster that kind of stuff pays for itself. Mm-hmm. So when we jumped from, like I said, 11,000 barrels in 2014 to about 30,000 barrels by the end of 2015. Obviously, we had to upgrade our centrifuge, and we chose the Flottweg. You guys were local. It's great having you guys 20 minutes away in Kentucky. So your level of service has been fantastic, and the machines performed wonderfully for us.
Right. Okay. And so now, when we're talking about some of the heavier beers or the material that's in the fermentation tanks, that's maybe not able to be handled by a separator. Mm-hmm. This is where the conversation began with using the decanter on the tank bottom. So talk a little bit about what tank bottoms are and why it's important to think about processing that material.
So in a modern fermentation tank, it's called a unitank. The key feature is a steep conical bottom that collects all the heavy solids, be it yeast or dry hops these days. Mm-hmm. And then you can pull all of that stuff off as a thick slurry to leave a cleaner, more processable beer. A traditional distack centrifuge is great for really light solids in that processable layer. Can't handle the heavy solids in the cone. So the challenge was, can we find a machine that can? Because even as you're dumping that stuff out, it looks really thick. You could still have up to 80% of that is beer. Mm-hmm. And normally you're sending that down the drain or sending it to a waste treatment system, which doesn't help anybody financially or environmentally.
Sure.
So it was key to find something that could. So when you guys came with the decanter, that was kind of a game changer for us, both so we could recover a lot of that beer out of those heavily hopped solids, but also help sidestream a lot of that. To pull it out of our municipal waste treatment system, which
understandable.
We're just now getting into surcharges and having to work with them on the on the waste treatment side. So being able to sidestream all of that saves us
point.
A lot.
Since installation, can you talk to like yield increases? You said it's up to 80% beer recoverable. Do you have some rough figures that are okay too?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. On say truth. Which is more than 50% of our production. That's our flagship IPA. We're seeing probably upwards of 10% yield increase per batch, which when you're doing 50 to 60,000 barrels a year, that adds up pretty quick.
Right.
So the machine, it paid for itself in under a year. So it was kind of a no-brainer when we you know, we got the test unit, the Z2, and that thing worked great. So we went ahead and got ourselves a 4, expecting to just let it rip. So it's the decanter and or the centrifuge for everything. But that's obviously helped take a lot of the load off the centrifuge.
Yeah.
Previously, we were running our disc stack around 40 to 80 barrels an hour, you know, at best. Now, post decanter, we can run some of our unfiltered juicy IPAs up to 140 barrels an hour, which is pretty crazy.
Yeah. That's a lot of throughput, that's for sure.
Yeah, so it's upped our throughput, and it's been easier on the machine, less discharges on the disc stack, so less maintenance overall, and better reliability.
Well, that's great.
I mean, look at your portfolio mix. How many hoppy beers are you doing? If at least half your portfolio is or more is hoppy, which most brewers probably are, I think a decanter is probably a smart choice. In fact, you guys have the Z2, which is a nice little skid-mounted system. It's pretty plug-and-play. I think that's a great option for a small regional player and craft brewer.
Yep. And Flottweg does have those trial units as well. So if there's a need to test those out, which I'm sure everybody would want to do ahead of time.
That's the easiest way to make the decision.
Yeah.
You know, we tested the unit 2 years ago now. And it was clear from the first run how beneficial it was, and it's pretty easy to do the math once you run that first tank through.
Excellent.
And that, you know, it either works or it doesn't. Try it out.
Yeah.
That's all I can say. Get the test unit.
And there's no trouble in doing that. It's a little bit of logistics getting the machine on site, running it with some of your product, and then you know, right? It's
exactly.
Not really a whole lot lost there.
Yep.
Cool. Thank you, man.
My pleasure.
It's always a pleasure. Thank you all for being here. We're at Rhinegeist. I'm Daniel Lakovich, Flottweg. We'll see you at the next one.